The class is called River Engineering and Restoration. The focus is on teaching students the design of rivers and how to manage them well. I think it's really important for the students to have some hands-on experience. We spend so much time behind our calculators. I think it's really important for them to see these places that they're making calculations on, to understand the context in which these calculations happen.
Desiree's river engineering class is great. We get a lot of practice with the classical engineering calculations and design work, but we also get to learn about rivers, about how they're constantly evolving and changing, and a river is more than just a channel. It's like a dynamic ecosystem that incorporates so many parts of our world, and that is like the lifeblood of why we get to be in these places.
Yeah, river engineering is this really awesome class where we try our best to make sense of such a dynamic system that is a river, being able to understand, oh, these rock fixtures are here. Oh, there's this type of vegetation or this type of substrate. I'm always looking at the velocity, I'm looking at the area, I'm estimating what kind of discharge I'm experiencing or seeing, and then being able to make predictions of what's going on upstream or downstream. Stuff like that is really, really fascinating to me.
It helps students think about the implications of their work for people, you know, for communities, for economies. And what I've seen in the students this weekend is a real appreciation for this place. They've had a chance to interact with a couple of different people working in different fields, realizing that it's not just about the morphology of the river, it's about the people who live here and the kinds of things that they value in terms of the future of the river.
It's hard to be a river person and not be aware of the environmental impacts humans have had at these places. From a longevity standpoint, it makes sense for us to pull the dams out, try to get this river corridor as healthy as possible, and be able to show the public what a dam-free stretch of the Klamath looks like. I feel a connection to the Klamath myself because I've been working up here for quite some time, and when you get to know a river really well, it feels like a friend.
There's no better way to inspire people to care about rivers than being on the river for a whole day and just being immersed and feeling the power and beauty of it.
So this is the largest dam removal project in history. There are four dams on the Klamath that are being removed this year and next year. Well, one of the challenges of working in the Klamath is the long-standing nature of some of the issues. So, you know, we've got water scarcity problems, especially as we get deeper into a multi-decadal drought. We've got water quality issues. We've got salmon passage issues. And then we have this kind of disconnect between the upper basin and the lower basin.
So historically, the Klamath was one of the highest, most plentiful salmon runs in the world. And over time, we've been noticing a very, very rapid decrease in those salmon populations. It affects the riparian area, but it also affects the community that rely on the salmon. And we've been investigating the impacts of dam removal and looking at what's gonna happen to the salmon population after those are removed.
You know, we get to be on this river right before it gets completely changed again and before it gets freed of four of six of the dams. And I think that was a really special moment to be sharing with the river and then all of my classmates who I'm very close with.
I get asked all the time, you know, if you were only to float one river, what would it be? And my response has always been anything new. I feel like we're just so lucky to have a new river that's gonna pop up in our backyard. You know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime event for a lot of us, and to have a new river suddenly emerge is a pretty special thing.
I hope the students will leave with some awareness of how their design actions impact the landscape and impact the people, but also some camaraderie amongst themselves, how we're all in this together, like that it's really about people as much as it is about engineering.
To me, the Klamath River is kind of a microcosm of everything that's happening in the West. As much as I appreciate the Klamath in its own right, I also think it can tell us a lot about water resource issues around the West.